Alright, we went and picked a new tool up today to help with our new gardening adventure and compost pile. We've got a lot of limbs down. We're going to take some small trees down and needed a way to make some of our own mulch. Instead of buying some mulch, we bought a little chipper shredder. It's a Predator from Harbor Freight. They're cheap. It's like the most inexpensive chipper you can probably get, I think, that I can find. About $500, $489. A little tax is like $520. Instead of buying mulch, which I know is pretty cheap, and burning everything that falls on the property, I'm going to just make my own mulch when I can. I have the materials to do it. So I looked at some reviews on Facebook on YouTube, and saw a lot of good stuff about them. And so we're gonna put it through the paces ourselves and see what it's made out of. See if it'll hold up to the abuse. We don't have very much property. We've got 3 acres. I'd like to buy the roughly two, 3 acres next to us. It's woods. Anyway, we're going to box it and put it together and get it going. Catch the wood chips. It comes with a stick.
Yeah, sack.
Yeah. It's Santa Claus's sack.
The white stuff.
It's you can put that to catch the wood chips if you want to put them in a bag. I don't know if we use that or not. We might try it. You want to do the job of taking the bubble wrap off? Got a little crate, so we're gonna walk around the shop. Little crowbar. I keep it in my work truck. I pry a lot of windows out of the frame with these doors. Am I gonna hurt you? Off. Yeah. I have to bring the other side out. It's kind of shoots on. It looks like the wheels are just not on it. So we're going to probably gonna cut the side out. Cut the side out of the box. Yeah. And that's a China crate. Comes with it. So I'm assuming we got a pin that's going to slide through here.
There's a little thing down there.
In the back? Oh yeah, there we go. Thanks, Caleb. We got a bag of hardware. Looks like some bushings. Cotter pins, a few bolts for the handle, some platen washers. All right, I'm gonna have to. Sun has came out and is blowing me out. It's roasting me out at the same time. And I gotta figure out a way to support this thing so I can get the whatever kickstand or whatever you want to call it, a little support stand on it. When I put the floor jack there, it's in the way or I can't bolt it up. So I'm gonna try to find another way to keep that thing supported and get that leg back on it, and then I'll get repositioned where we can film it a little more. And then we're gonna put this thing through the paces. It's we bought the cheapo because that's all we can afford, and it looked like it'll rip through some wood according to some other people's videos on YouTube. So we're gonna put it in the paces. I'm gonna spin you around and show you. We got all these pine trees right here we're gonna tackle, and we got a bunch of cherry trees we've got to do some pruning on, and quite a lot of pruning around the property. So crouching down so I don't adjust the camera. All right, so we're gonna regroup here in just a minute. All right, I'm gonna pull this door down. Okay, maybe that'll keep it from blowing us out so bad. Roll down some more. Okay. All right, we figured out a way to support it. Caleb's gonna kind of just keep it balanced. So I've got it on the floor jack, and there's something on the lens. Hope you can't see that. We're gonna try to get it knocked out real quick. I'm going to use some wrenches to tighten this thing up. Basically, if you've ever worked on a go-kart or a tiller or anything like that, the four holes in the bottom of the engine, you normally mount that onto a plate, like on the back of a go-kart or a tiller or something. That's where these stands, just four bolts go up to it. Rubber shock absorber, that's it.
Caleb, you need to go up there.
It's so hot in here. I rolled the metal door back down. It's July. It's like 95 degrees outside. It's insanely hot. I don't even see the sweat dumping off of me for 5 minutes maybe at work. I'm just drenched. 5 minutes. We're going to put some oil on it. I'm going to throw this upper handle on it.
Where did the handle go?
This handle on it. Like so. And when we get back, we will, when we get done with that, put some oil in it, put the handle on it, fire it up, let it warm up, break it in for a second, and then we're going to throw this thing through its paces here in just a little while. All right. Alright, so we got the handles on it, got the wheels on it, got gas in it, got oil in it. We're gonna fire it up, get the brakes set on. I fired it up once, it vibrates across the floor by itself if you don't set the brakes. No big deal. You just gotta have the brakes set. I see why they have brakes on it now, because it vibrates so much, it wants to walk across the concrete. We're gonna get cleaned up a little bit. I'm gonna let this thing run for about 10 minutes, let it cool back off, just kind of give a little break-in procedure. The manual says 5, I say 10, let it cool off for 15, 20 minutes, and then we'll try it again. I got to charge the AC on this Hummer over here. I put a water pump on it. It's having some AC troubles too, so I'm going to go ahead and do that while I heat up and cool down this, and then it's so blazing hot out right now, I don't feel like doing anything outside. I don't feel like doing anything in here. I want to go inside where the air conditioning's at. Don't have the opportunity right now. So we're going to do our heat and cool down, and then we'll make a little video running some wood through it. I'll see if I can't fire it up and hold this camera by myself. And, so I let it run for about a minute just to, it's so bright in here. This video's going to be blown out, I'm sure. There she is in all her glory. Got oil in it. Use your on-off switch. So you just flip it on. I choked it once. I got the throttle pretty far up. Let's see what... Choke it again. As loud as I thought it would be. Alright, I'm good now. Trying to get inside. Get the space to run outside. My cool's off a little bit tonight. Alright, it's much later in the day now. It's about 8 o'clock at night. Sun's starting to go down. We got about, I don't know, maybe an hour, 45 minutes of daylight left. And we're going to just run this thing for a few minutes and see how it does. We're not going to try to jam anything big in it. Just because the instructions say to kind of take it easy on it for
20 hours, but I don't think I'll take it easy 20 hours. But we're going to take it easy for at least 30 minutes that we're going to play with it tonight. So we're going to work on this little little limb pile we've got here, which was going to be burned, but we decided to start making mulch out of it instead of burning everything. We're going to stay away from some of the bigger stuff and just try to run some of the little stuff through it. And we got quite a lot of vegetation we're going to start trimming down and sticking in the mulcher. But we're going to go fire this thing up and put our ear protections on. Get going. These boys have to go to school in the morning. First day back after the Rona. So we, I've learned a little bit about compost piles over the weekend, and an open one like this takes a long time to break down because there's not enough heat retention. So I'm going to end up probably making some sort of a bag system to start putting this in to hold heat so it'll break down faster instead of just having open air. Plus we have a lot of rabbits and critters and stuff running around out here in the woods. Groundhogs, beavers,
deer.
Rabbit, deer, we've got coyotes, we've got it all. There's no telling what's going to be eaten out of this pile when we start putting vegetable scraps on here. Those watermelon rinds you see there on the top of the pile, I had shoved down in the top of that dirt last night, so something has moved a few of them. I'm assuming the rabbits are probably out here gnawing on them. Anyway, we're going to fire this thing up and see what happens here. Caleb, I brought your gloves out here. I bought this pair of gloves at O'Reilly's when I was getting some parts for this Hummer I'm working on the other day. And I thought the price tag on the shelf said like $2.99 or something. So I normally buy the Carhartt leather gloves, and they last okay. These things are probably junk, but then I would never buy white gloves, but I looked at the wrong shelf when I picked them up. They were like $11 when they rang them up. I was like, man, they'd already rang them up, so I took them. I don't expect them to last long doing the firewood. But, all right. You turn these on so they cancel the noise. These Bose noise canceling earbuds are awesome. They drowned out everything. I'm gonna find my tunes and turn them on. Listen to a little Cadillac Sky.